Hey everybody, it's 40 Warrior. Welcome back to Donkey Kong 64. Last time I embarrassed myself and then totally redeemed myself in the retro Donkey Kong game. And, well, we made it to the testing area and now making it into the R&D room. Now, this is definitely the shortest floor of the four. And there's a lot of R&D doors that say R&D, so yeah, something to keep in mind. Now, even though there's a, it's a really small floor, they actually do stash quite a few bananas here. Like, I know Lanky has two alone. The first one being up here, because up here is going to be my old buddy, Chris Platt. Who says you're allowed to do that? I didn't give you the okay, so you're going to screw up. And the second one is right over there, I believe. Also, don't worry about the lava. I'm not sure why the heck it's here, but maybe it's a decoration? But it's a silly decoration if it is. I notice the trombone lags, but the music can lag a bunch, too. The audio doesn't, but the musical instrument thing will. Yep, and now we get to play the belch a bit. I guess. We get to do our own belching music. You thought belching the ABCs was bad. This is just... even as a guy, this is kind of like, not a territory you want to go down. The pattern never changes, no matter how many times you play this, so you'll always see this. And if you think about it, it's actually kind of a simple pattern so far. I mean, C, B, C, D, E. And then it goes back to C, so that, I guess, is supposed to complicate things, but really doesn't. Really, the toughest part is maybe whiffing on the Simian Slam. Which I've seen happen a couple times. I've been not too pleased about it. The next one should be A. B, E, C, A. F never gets used. They shun the F. After that, golden banana.
Oh, banana.
Just like that. And Lanky's got three already. Four, actually. I'm trying to remember, where is Lanky? Oh, I know where Lanky's for this. It's in the production room, along with everything else. Because everybody else has, everybody has a banana in the production room, at least. DK, I believe, has two, though. No, actually, he has three. He has a tricky curse splat there, too. So, on through here, Tiny's got a pretty fun challenge of her own. Oh, yeah, DK's got his, got something there. Oh, I think I know what that is. Either way, it's unimportant. I'm taking care of Tiny's thing right now. And you go through the rare symbol thing, you meet up with this race car. Nice set of wheels, Tiny. Let's race this golden banana trophy, shall we? To win, you'll have to beat me over two laps and collect 10 coins. Try pressing Z to speed up and use the control stick to change lanes. Press A to cheat. Yes. Remember what I said? If you are cheating, you are trying. The DK stars will give you very good boosts, and they're usually hinted at by the something like that. The cheating thing is basically missile down the lane so you can whip the car. Oh yeah, and mine the TNT barrels. You only have a limited set of missiles though, so just bear that in mind. Now I got 10. I can't cheat. Cheat. Now if you remember where the DK boosts are. Thanks for keep running into the TNT barrels. You're doing it so I don't have to. Normally I run into a few TNT barrels, which kind of sucks. But not this time, which is kind of funny. I don't remember him running into this many TNT barrels. I really don't. Why are there so many TNT barrels on this one lane? There we go. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Of course, I'm running into so many TNT barrels. Probably helped me out because I didn't have to collect too many coins. I think that's the first time I've gone through this without actually hitting a TNT barrel. Being by a monkey. That sucks. Or should we say, being by the TNT barrel. I mean, I understand running headlong and racing with a... you know, a double make care attitude. But that's just kind of taking it a little far. I almost feel bad for him. Almost. Anyway. I got some to do a DK over here, so. Let me take care of that. Actually, let me not take care of that right now, because there's two things I can do with DK over here. So Chunky and Diddy have stuff over here too, so. Yeah, they gave you a shit ton of balloons here. I mean. Got it. 73 bananas. And now we have numbers here. So, very simple. Pound the number. 1342. And get ready for a fight. I think if you press incorrect, combination, you have to fight enemies, but it doesn't count towards your goal. I don't remember though. It's been a long time. So after doing this, we meet up with a couple enemies. And Mecha Zingers. Thankfully, they give you infinite stuff to do this with, so. You are never gonna run out of ways to get rid of stuff. And I think even the crystal coconuts are hypnotized. This has gotta hurt though. That baseball cap does not provide too much protection. And well, this set right here really just. Okay. That's that. And through here, I believe, is going to be a couple RoboCrims. So if you really want to be a stickler about it, maybe the first one's the toughest, simply because of the Mecha Zingers, and the fact they're probably the toughest things to hit out of everything that you've seen at this point. And just like that, we're all done. Although they do have an agonizingly long demise. And just like that, we're done. so you have some exceedingly easy battles. But that's not the only one who has a battle. Chunky has a battle here, too, if memory serves me right. Yep. This is gonna be kind of fun. And actually pretty creative, in my opinion. Chunky, you can grab onto the ladder now. No one stopped you. I just think this is really annoying sounding. No disrespect to anybody who likes it. I just don't. And remember, just because I don't like something does not mean you have to give me death threats over it. Okay? It took me a while to warm up to chocolate milk, if you can believe that. And that's probably the most un-American offense that exists. Well, next to not liking bacon. Because if you don't like bacon, I can't help you. If you don't like bacon, I will bleepity bleep 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 you. Nah, I'm kidding. If you don't like bacon, you don't like bacon. I don't have a problem with it. I just can't simply imagine a world without bacon. Anyway, what we got here is a bunch of enemies. First, one Mr. Dice. And then, two of these things. Which provide no real challenge. And then a couple of Sir Dominoes, and then all of a sudden, the big guys. Dominoes, those weird things, a bunch of these one, two, three things, which basically all merge to form into this one Megazord type thing. Yep. Kind of like in Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, you get to grow big, and you get to start... Just hit and run is usually your best option. Because he likes doing that. Of course, we always do private punches just for the hell of it. I wonder if this works. Also, this is Chunky's name. Oh, it does work, but it doesn't work as well as you'd hope. Well, I'm kind of cool with that, actually. It'd be kind of cheap if that was actually all it took. If you're wondering, I don't believe you can actually use your triangle here. Hey, that hit. Well, some of these just aren't hitting, even though I'm definitely making contact. Look, we gave you an infinite amount of coke guns to do this with. And there you go. It's not a very hard fight. It's just kind of cool. And obviously, I mean, the hit and run strategy is pretty much undefendable strategy, so. Yeah, that's kind of the way you have to go about it. If you stand in the pocket and try to slug your way through, you'll probably lose. Because the guy doesn't have any stun time. Now, we got two things we can do here with DK, and that's probably what I'm going to do to finish up with the R&D floor. The first thing here was actually follow where Tiny went, because you saw that footplate. And if we look at toy sales, now I got... We start off with no toys and no time, and then we started really busting out the toys. And we've been doing well, but we've hit a bit of a decline recently. In light of the recent economy that was in... When was this game made? 2000... No, it wasn't made in the 2000s, dude. Jeez, you dingbat, the N64 came out in the 90s. I thought we had good economic prospects in the 90s, though. I only know it's been too long since we've had a good economy. And regardless of what the stocks are saying now, we definitely aren't in a good economy now, so. Yeah. Anyway, all this div just opened up this. So might as well take care of it right now. While the Curse Blatch is running at me, I'm failing miserably. Harini Ambush will feature Curse Blatch. These guys are a pain in the ass. I mean, you can take care of them this way, but if there's other Krellings that are breathing down your neck, I wouldn't advise it. That might be your best option. Curse Blast do take a longer time to recharge. But you'll be basically seeing some sort of variation of this as you go through these arenas. Just remember the shock because you'll be using that a lot in the future. And like I said, the Curse Blatch will sort of this disparty you off the thing if you're not careful. Now, what I've been wanting to do for all this time has been do this with DK. Because I want to open this. And go through here. And through here. Banana metal. Ring, 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 ring. Banana metal. This is probably the most important golden banana in this level. Because now we have activated the factory. Which means now we have access to a lot more golden bananas. Way more than you could imagine, and a lot more bananas we can collect too. Oh, and DK's other banana is here. Right in there, actually. And Banana Port 4 now has relevance. Now, of course, you did notice the Diddy switch there, so I'll be right back and I'll go through this and I'll get Diddy. Okay, now, time to take care of business with Diddy. Even though you have 20 seconds to do this, the reality is this. If you mess up, you really don't have 20 seconds to recover. This one can be pretty annoying, because the trick is to actually force the beavers to go into the pit. But if they're right on the edge, they won't go in, so you gotta sort of run around them and force them to go in, like so. Just run around in circles and hope. And this can be very annoying. Oh, and the most important thing of all, don't jump in the pit. That's an instant loss. But the beavers have to basically run into the pit. You can't just sort of keep them on the edge and teeter, because they won't move if they're in that position. That was actually one of the better runs for me. Beaver Bother can be very tricky to start. Very frustrating. Even though you would think controlling your clutch would be kind of cool. Now, I do know where Diddy's Curse Blatch is, so I'm actually going to head there right now. And take care of business. He's got his, nice. Oh yeah, now watch out when you cross from here, because that can happen. Which will hurt you a little bit. I mean, it's not a huge deal, but it exists. And there we go. Now I'm going to use Diddy to actually scale this first. No real reason other than, oh, I just had Diddy. Most of these are not timed, thankfully. Although there is a couple of surfaces in the world. And, well, scaling this for the first time can be a bit of a pain. So, trick is just be precise with your jumps, and that kind of is what causes the issue. I mean, you gotta run on stupid pipes and shit, which can prove be. How to actually stay up and recover? That might be. Fucking cling! This. Recovery! Dave, stop controlling this fucking corner! Oh my god, you fucking bastard! That wasn't fun! That was not fun! I told you I hate the cling function in this, right? Like, Mario mastered it. This is the mass. This is like the toilet bowl version. If Mario's thing is a Super Bowl, that was the toilet bowl. Anyway, now the toughest part is actually jumping on this arm right here, because it moves pretty fast. So you gotta lead your jump a little bit. And nail that. Thankfully, once you stay on it, that's that. Just basically wait for the platform to show in. There you go. Now we don't have to worry about that annoying bit of climbing. That's easily the most annoying bit right there. As you can tell from the whole clinging problem. Hey, I'm not laughing. Alright, I am laughing, because that was ridiculous. Now anyway. The thing does follow the same pattern the whole time. It's just basically speed up, slow down, stop, over and over again. And you just heard the first splat right there. And that is DK, so that's definitely the most out of the way first splat. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna finish up DK and then I'm gonna stop this part. Because I did say there were two things here that DK could get. So, first being the first plat. If you're on a turbine like this that's moving really fast, just jump rapidly. I'm not even gonna chance it. When he shoots you, it's gonna hurt. When you fuck up your jump, that is going to hurt as well. Oh, some bitch. Whatever. I'll just do this first. Don't care. I have 85 gold, but 85 bananas, so I don't care about this. There's blue. Some stuff here. But yeah, there's a link in here, believe it or not. There we go. We got it. Yeah, there's way too much chaos here. You definitely want the strong card to go back. And we're out of here. Anyway, back to what I was trying to do and failed miserably at. Yeah, I'm coming for you, Chris Platt. I'm coming for you. And I'm not taking no for an answer this time. Well, technically, I didn't take no for an answer last time either. I just simply botched the jump. Which is sort of like, my body telling me, screw you, or whatever. Okay, screw you. Not short-arming this one. And that's where I'm gonna end this, and I'll finish off the rest of the golden bananas in the next part. See you then, 40 Warriors, signing off.